Hey guys, it's your boy Cabrews, and welcome back to my Favorite 16, Liverpool Chroma, where last off I picked up wins in the league and in the Capital One Cup. And I also had a little rant, just a little one, about Liverpool. Well, if you saw all Liverpool's last two games, not their last two games, but their last game against West Ham, you'll know they didn't listen! It's incredible! They didn't listen! Because they went out and West Ham again. Now, no disrespect to West Ham. They deserve to win. They deserve to win all the games. They did. But how? Who has it not become crystal clear to Jurgen Klopp yet that you cannot play Christian Benteke? Just don't do it. I don't care who you play up front instead. Just don't play Christian Benteke and we might have a chance to win a game. Because to win a game, you have to score goals, which is something that Christian Benteke doesn't do. He does not score goals. He is a striker who does not score goals. I don't know what to call that. The first word in my head would be pointless, useless. Those would be the words in my head, but you know. Oh, that's just me. So yeah, once again, we've absolutely wasted money on a striker. Or we've not had a good striker signing since Luis Suarez.
So a couple of strikers for them at the front.
Having some shit like Christian Benteke and Andy Carroll. Granted, Andy Carroll has, when he's fit, he's good for West Ham. But for Liverpool, he was shit. And Christian Benteke is shit. And I knew from the second we signed Christian Benteke that it was a bad idea. Why? He doesn't fit our system. This was always the problem. We do not play a style that suits a tall player. That is why we got rid of Andy Carroll. And who made that decision to play a style who didn't fit a tall striker and get rid of Andy Carroll? Was it Jurgen Klopp? No. Who was it? Oh yeah, it was Brendan Rodgers. Brendan Rodgers got rid of Andy Carroll. Brendan Rodgers decided he wanted to play a style that didn't fit a tall striker. Fair enough. No, not suited for a striker who can't play with the ball at his feet. You know, he's not as good with his feet as he is with his head. Benteke isn't as good with his feet as he is with his head. He is deadly in the air. I mean, if we did have a style that suited Christian Benteke, he might actually have a lot more goals, and we might be higher in the table. Well, then again, we still have to contend with our shit defense. I'll get to them in a minute. But I don't see. If we do not sign a striker in the summer, then we may as well not compete in the Premier League next season, because we won't get anywhere for next season either. Because to get high in the table, or to get to the top four where we want to be, we will need at least a striker who will score 15 to 20 goals. Will Christian Benteke get us 15 to 20 goals? No. Oh, now, there's this striker. He's available in summer. He wants to come to the Premier League. His name is Lacazette. Sign him up, Klopp. I don't care how much you have to pay. Just fucking pay it. Okay. Lacazette will get us 15 to 20 goals. Hell, he might even get into 30. Because he is an amazing player. Everyone knows this. And Let's look at the other Premier League teams. Manchester City, are they going to sign him? No. Not unless they sell a striker first. But, you know, I don't think Lacazette will be someone Guardiola goes for. I think Guardiola will look more towards better known players, you know. It just doesn't seem like a signing Guardiola would go for. He's probably going to look to bring in maybe a Bayern Munich player or two. I don't even know if he'll sign a striker. I don't think City need one. I mean, they just need to be more consistent. That's been the reason they're not top of the table. That and Leicester are brilliant this season. And Arsenal. Will Arsenal sign him? Absolutely not, because Arsene Wenger has reduced his purchasing to one player per transfer window, and he doesn't think Arsenal needs a striker. So, yeah, sorry Arsenal, but Lacazette won't be coming to the Emirates. Or any other striker, probably. He just talked to Wenger. He does not think you need a striker, so. Oh well. Next is Spurs. Would Spurs need him? No. Because they have Harry Kane. Unless, for some bizarre reason, they sell Harry Kane, which. Unless they get an offer matching Gareth Bale level all the money, they're not going to sell Harry Kane. So that's the top four. Let's look at the other teams. Let's look at Leicester. Will Leicester need him? No. They have Jamie Vardy, top goal scorer in the Premier League. Granted, he is probably going to leave in the summer. Let's be honest here, Leicester. I don't care if he did just sign a new contract. When has that ever stopped players from leaving? Answer, never.
And the kickoff for the second half of their second game in the Champions Cup group.
So, sorry to Leicester fans, but Vardy, he will probably go to a bigger club, even if you do win the league, so sorry about that. And yeah. Morris will probably go too. So, yeah. But on the plus side, at least get as much money as you can from them and, you know, spend it wisely. You got Jamie Vardy for 1 million, so, you know, clearly you're good at spending your money wisely. You just don't do what Liverpool do. Don't take any spending any advice from us. Well, Brendan Rodgers. Specifically. Just don't take any transfer target advice from him and you'll be fine.
Out of the danger zone. He's shut off now. Well blocked. It's behind for another corner.
Now let's look at other Premier League clubs. Manchester United. A possibility, but with Martial, I don't think Man United are going to look to sign a new striker. I think they see Martial as their top striker for the next 20 years. And fair play, he could easily be. He started off really good. You know, his form has dipped. It doesn't help that Van Gaal has moved him out wide because Pie was useless.
Some danger to the opposition now they're here. Can he do it? Oh, great work by the keeper.
But yeah.
He's crossed it well.
Man United, could they sign Lacazette? It could possibly happen, but I don't think so. I think they're going to stick with Martial. And of course, they still have Wayne Rooney. So, sorry, Man United fans, but I don't think you'll be signing Lacazette. But then again, I still see it as maybe a possibility, probably more likely than any of the 8 teams above you. So, there's that. And then we come to West Ham, who are another team up in the top bunch. Well, a team above Liverpool, anyway. Do West Ham need a striker? I'm going to say no. I mean, Antonio is a really good player. Valencia is a really good player. They got rid of Zarate, which confuses the hell out of me. He was a really good player as well. The fact that he got like 7.5 million it was a really weird transfer. He's gone to Fiorentina. I'm like, what? It confused the hell out of me. I'm sure a lot of West Ham fans were scratching their head as well. And you still have Andy Carroll. Oh, when he's fit, like I said, when he's fit, he is very good for you. Ooh. And, you know, sometimes, you know, hopefully, maybe you can get him fit again. Who knows? Then again, that's like Liverpool hoping Daniel Sturridge will stay fit. It's probably not very likely. But, yeah.
2-1. Well, the rain has been very heavy.
Who else is above? Just starting to ease a bit. Thank goodness. Yeah, I was getting wet up here. League table in my head. Tussle between the two of them, try and get the ball. He's cut out that pass. It wasn't an accident. He read the mind of the opponent. Here's the cross, and it's a headed chance now. Great goal! Can't think of it. Hang on a second.
Something of a dying art amongst players these days, the ability to use the neck muscles like that. Great header. Well, I want to see this again, this goal. The scoreline as we restart the game. 3-1 here, and that could be that really, given the lack of time left. What do you think for the next game?
Well, Liverpool go up against Spurs, and they've done pretty well out here. I'll be pleased.
Southampton and Everton, those are your two teams. Okay, let's look at them. Southampton, do they need a new striker? No, because they actually just got Charlie Austin in the January transfer window for a hell of a bargain at £4 million. Because, well, he was the asking price in the freaking summer window was £15 million. So,
and here's the cross. He can't miss. In with a header.
Yeah, very good, shrewd business work there by Southampton. And Everton, again, no, because they have Lukaku, who actually fits Everton's style, because he does very, very well for Everton. And he scores a lot of goals. So, looking at the teams above us, barring Man United and I don't think City. I mean, that's the top 9, because next is Liverpool. And do we need a striker? Yes, because our best strikers are currently still coming back from injuries, and our best fully fit striker, well, we don't have one. Because I'm not even going to call Christian Benteke a striker until he starts playing like a striker, and not some random person off the street. Then again, some random person off the street would probably do better than Christian Benteke. So, yeah. Good work, dumbass. It's an absolute disgrace, you know. It is an absolute disgrace. And, yeah. I think it's fair to say if Lacazette is looking to come to the Premier League, Liverpool just need to pay the money. Because, like I made very good points about all the teams above us on why they will either not look to or won't sign Lacazette. And if he's looking to come to the Premier League, Liverpool need a striker. Why not? Why not? Let's put the money on the table. Let's put as much money, give Leon what they want. Doesn't fucking matter. You know, if he gets us top four, which I believe if he bangs in the goals like we know he can, he could easily, we would definitely challenge. We'd definitely be up there. Would we get top four guaranteed? We would definitely have to strengthen the defense, but our attack would be much, much better. And like I said, now, maybe you guys in the comment section below will disagree, but I think those are all very good points on why Lacazette should and will choose Liverpool. We know he wants to come to the Premier League, and all the other options are below Liverpool, to be honest. Like, Newcastle were already interested in him, and he told Newcastle to practically go fuck themselves, so yeah, he's obviously looking to come to one of the higher teams in the league because he probably saw that Newcastle were down there at the bottom. So, what Liverpool need to do is somehow just keep our, you know, get Origi or probably get Origi because keeping Daniel Sturridge fit is probably impossible at this point. So get Origi fully fit, get him into the starting lineup, play him in every single match until the end of the season. Do not play Christian Benteke for any reason ever again. Just sell the bastard in the summer for a bag of Doritos. Oops. That's very disrespectful for Doritos, but that's the first thing that came to mind. And why, I don't know. I don't know how much a bag of Doritos costs, but I'm sure they're worth more than Christian Benteke. So, let's get rid of Benteke, get in a striker who will actually fit our system, and will actually bag us some goals. Then, here's a crazy idea. Let's sign some good defenders, sign a good goalkeeper, and then we can focus on getting top four, because right now we'll never get top four again. And I'm a Liverpool fan. So, yeah. So here's the little, here's the catch to the Liverpool board. Give Klopp all the money you can. Give him all the money you have. Seriously, just tell him, go out, spend as much as you want. Don't give a shit about financial fair play, because it won't come into effect till next season, if at all, because Man City can spend whatever the fuck they like, and if they can, so can we. So, spend as much as you like. Here you go. Here's our checkbook. We're a very rich group. So, you have as much as you like. It doesn't matter how much you spend, as long as you get good players, and you get a top four, and perhaps maybe even, and here's the crazy thing, if we sign the right players and get the right, and fix the problems in the team, who knows, in a few seasons, not immediately, not expecting Klopp to work miracles. But yeah, maybe in a few seasons, maybe the title, who knows? At least, I mean, if you can get this team to the Cap or One Cup final with good players, you could probably win the league anyway, so, you know, maybe you can work miracles, who knows? But, you know, it is the Capital One Cup, so we're not gonna go overboard just yet, but we are gonna give you, here's the checkbook, just spend as much as you want, just spend as much as you need.
The way the team are playing.
Yeah, the stats don't lie, the number of shots on...
Get good players, fix this shamble of a mess that we call a team, and yeah. Don't care about financial fair play. It's not important. It's not. It's really not. If Manchester City can spend as much as they like, so can we. And even if they do, who limit our spending, once we have the good players, it won't fucking matter. So, yeah. I implore us to say fuck financial fair play, because it doesn't matter, because City seem, because it certainly doesn't seem to matter to Manchester City, and so either we do it and we get away with it, like Man City have, or we do it and we don't get away with it, but we have good players and we can build a team.
Liverpool will get the throw.
So we can't spend and a high amount of money for a few seasons. So what? If we have good players, then it won't fucking matter, right? Yeah, exactly.
Way of that, blocked it well.
So, let's just go on a mad spending spree and just buy what we need. And that's a whole new back line. Well, except for a right back, because Nathaniel Klein's been indecent this season. So we need two new centre backs, a new goalkeeper, preferably one whose name isn't Mignolet, and a new left back, because unless you want to play Joe Gomez when he comes back, which I'd be fine with, because he's much better than Alberto Moreno, who's a piece of shit. Yeah, Moreno, you're a piece of shit. If you ever see this, you're a piece of shit. And every Liverpool fan hates you. So, feel free to leave. We won't miss you. Trust us. We won't miss you.
He's got the technique as well as the vision to switch the play. Danny Rose.
Because right now, I would sooner have Jose Enrique back in the starting 11 than play the Alberto Moreno. Because every time Alberto Moreno plays, he does something stupid. Case in point, the Norwich game.
Bale. And he's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
So, yeah.
He's kept it out. And the decision is a corner here.
That's what needs to happen. And that's what needs to happen in the summer. The Liverpool owners need to give Klopp their checkbook, tell him spend as much as he needs. He fixes it's the club by getting a new striker, new defenders, new goalkeeper, and we're sorry. Because Klopp will make the right signings. He's not Brendan Rodgers.
only just missed it.
Why he didn't make it any signs in the January transfer window, you know, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, really looking forward to this one. I think we're going to see some good football.
So yeah, let's focus on the game, shall we? Currently 1-0 up against Spurs after that 4-1 win over Anderlecht. Neymar! Neymar again! Yes! 2-0! Well, it looks like 3 points. It's again. 10th goal of the season for Neymar. He's creeping up on in Korea. He's only 1 goal behind him now. Or is it 2? Might be 2. I think Korea has 11 or 12, I'm not sure. If it's 11, then it's 1 goal between them now, and if it's 12, then it's 2. Simple as that, really.
And a fine bail,
Bale! Oh, Bale scores against his former club! Bale scores against Spurs, and everyone is delighted. Look at them all, they're all celebrating, they're all like, hey, Bale's back. Oh wait, he plays for the other team now. Oh shit. Great control, powers it into the bottom corner, didn't go give Lloris much of a chance, actually he gave him no chance whatsoever. And for Gareth Bale, it's good to be back.
Well, they've widened the margin now.
That is 3 points definitely wrapped up in the most ironic of fashion. Hooray!
From Watford. It's a goal for Crystal Palace. It's been scored by Bakary Sakho. The keeper had come out for a cross and failed. The break is definitely on. Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance. Offside is the call. We can see it again, which of course the officials can't. No, they get one.
God damn it.
He's dealt well with his chance. He's made the correct call. And that news from Alan McAnally that we had to interrupt. A goal for Crystal Palace. Scores 2-1. Past his man there.
Neymar.
Shots off. Very good stop here. It's a wonderful
penalty!
Well, that should be a penalty. Well, it's a penalty, and the referee...
Other wheel, well, I think it was, yeah.
It's the composure, haven't I? It's been a poor day, and it's only going to get worse here. And entering the match, Emmanuel Adebayor.
Marco Reus from the penalty spot. Oh, Lloris with a fantastic save!
Going to pay the penalty for this, but the goal...
What an absolute amazing save. Credit to him.
He used it there, didn't he?
Marco Reus thought he was going to make it 4-0. Oh, but not today. At least not then.
The goalkeeper with a textbook save.
Netting the ball into the boxes straight to the hands of Lloris. to this point. He having conceded 3 goals, and definitely he's not going to get anything from this match except maybe a consolation goal. I was going to say if they had taken that free kick early, but they didn't. Yeah, that's very easily cleared. That's away, that should be a full-time ref. Come on. It's down the end of the pitch. And Lamela's gonna get there way before anyone else. There's the full-time whistle. Well, they didn't even get a consolation goal. Oh. That's how bad it was for Spurs. Three nil. Oh, domination, you know, just domination. And Everton dropped points. I'm celebrating because they were in second. So, yeah, they're still in second. But yeah, they dropped 2 points, which is great. 6 points is the gap between me and them now, which is a hell of a gap, actually. Yeah, that's Sam Miles. Well, you're away. Either way, new youth player, I guess. Oh wait, I got future talent thing, didn't I? That's what that is. I'd completely forgotten for a second that I had used that, so that's why I was like, huh? Who? But now I know you, friend. Now I know who you are. Get you some train drills. Yeah. Who else? Why not put Pullet in for a training drop? But yeah. In the next episode, I think I have a Sheffield Wednesday and Inter Milan. Two really tough games. No doubt I can pick up wins in. And so, well, and thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Hey, smash the like button and subscribe for more our videos soon. And leave in the comment section below what you think about my argument for Lacazette at probably joining Liverpool in the summer, or and what do you think one of those other teams do need a striker. Well, Arsenal need a striker, but they won't sign one. And it's 11 goals for Correa. I can just see that now. Look at that. 11-10-4. But yeah. Thanks for watching. Enjoy, and until next time. I hope you all.